So you were the one fighting Darkspawn. I thought I heard combat. You're the elf I found wandering the forest, aren't you? I'm surprised you have recovered. It's a pleasure to finally meet you. The last time we spoke, you were barely conscious.
And Daran Atishan, Duncan of the Grey Wardens. I am Meryl, the Keeper's apprentice.
Your Keeper did not send you after me, did she? I told her I would be in no danger. So, you and your friend Tamlin both entered this cave, and you saw this mirror. I see. That's unfortunate. The Grey Wardens have seen artifacts like this mirror before. It is Tevinter in origin, used for communication. Over time, some of them simply break. They become filled with the same taint as the Darkspawn. Tamlin's touch must have released it. It's what made you sick. And Tamlin too, I presume. I agree. So long as the mirror exists, it is a threat to anyone nearby.
I do not fear this sickness. The Keeper knows how to cure it.
She may have weakened it, but she cannot cure it. Your recovery is only temporary. I can sense the sickness in you, and it is spreading. Look inside yourself, and you will see. First, we deal with the mirror. It is a pestilence and a threat. It is done. Now let's leave this cursed place. I must speak with the Keeper immediately regarding your cure. I sense no other Darkspawn nearby, so it's safe. Lead on.
I'm relieved you have returned, and I did not expect to see you again so soon, Duncan.
I was not expecting to return so soon either, Keeper.
Dare I ask of Tamlin? What did you find of him? I see. Meryl, what about the mirror? Did you bring anything back?
I can answer that, Keeper. I destroyed the mirror.
I intended to use it to find a cure for this mysterious illness. I trust you had good reasons for your actions.
There is much to discuss, Keeper. I have learned a great deal since I was last here.
Let us speak privately within my Aravel, then, Duncan. Meryl, warn the hunters. If Darkspawn are about, I want the clan prepared.
Manuvinen, Keeper. Right away.
Darlene, allow me some time to speak with Duncan. Seek us out at my Aravel later, and we can discuss your cure. Tell Hiren Pyvel what has occurred. He now has the sad task of preparing a service for the dead. Follow me, Duncan. I'm eager to hear what you have to say.
So you return with the Grey Warden, but without Tamlin. What happened, Dalen? Is he truly lost to us? So, another of our children has perished. To think I'd live to see this. It seems the will of the creators that I sing the dirge for those I held in my arms as babes. I think I know why our immortal ancestors would sleep. Swiftly do stars burn a path across the sky, hastening to place one last kiss upon your eye. Tenderly land enfolds you in slumber, softening the rolling thunder. Dagger now sheathed, bow no longer tense. During this, your last hour, only silence. Our ancestors did not age as we do. The Shemlin brought a quickening to our blood that changed us forever. Instead of death, those weary of life would pass into Uthanera, the waking slumber. In doing this, they made way for the young. It was supposed to be a beautiful time, a celebration of the Elder's long life and contribution to his people. Alas, we have no such ceremonies these days. Of course. We've no body to return to the soil, but we shall still sing for Tamlin. The creators must come to guide him to the beyond. Tell the Keeper, it shall be done before the clan is ready to move on. You know, it's imperative now more than ever to pass on what we know to the young. Let us tell these children of the fall of the Dales. You can honor me by sharing in the telling. Come then, help me as I go along. Children, hear of the fall of the Dales. Hear the tale of what makes you Dalish. Would you care to begin, Dalen? Let us start with the history that makes us Dalish. When we were slaves. Yes, slaves to a terrible empire, the humans built on the darkest magic. When it fell, we became free. We built a homeland in the Dales, worshiping the creators and rebuilding the culture and history we lost in our long years of slavery. But the humans would not leave us be. They were resentful. Because we would not worship their gods, and because we put our people first. Over the years, their nations grew cold toward the Dales. In their eyes, we were blasphemers and cruel tyrants. A war erupted. The humans invaded our homeland in the name of their one god, denouncing our sacrilegious nation. And so the Dales fell. They took our lands and dispersed our people, forcing us to live in their cities and abandon our gods. But many of us refused to relinquish our ways. We instead chose to scatter to the winds, wandering the lands, to survive and preserve our culture. The clans stay apart until the day the Elvenan have a homeland once more. We shall then return the old ways to those of our people who have lost them. We are the Dalish, keepers of the lost lore, walkers of the lonely path. The oath of the Dales, and no smart-mouth comment. Thank the creators for small mercies. I will let you get on with your business now. Of course. May the gods guide your path, Dalen.